Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Risha and this is For the Love of Classics. 4 months ago, I did a poll on my YouTube channel asking you guys for suggestions for future videos. The highest vote was for the bookshelf tour. I have been avoiding making that video because I wasn't happy with how my bookshelf was looking. But recently I moved things around. I keep changing the setting for a change, and I recently moved my bookshelf again. And when I did that, I redecorated it. I feel like now I'm happy with how things are looking. In the last couple of months, I bought a lot of books and my bookshelf was full. I did not have any place for them. But now I have thought up of another place for my books, and now I have put them on my TV table. So I'm going to show you that in a bit. The last bookshelf tour I did was back home in Pakistan. I loved how the books were arranged in my bookshelf in Pakistan, but I'm really happy with how things are looking right now as well. Obviously, these are not all of my books. I do have my books back home in Pakistan as well. But today's video is going to be a bookshelf tour from my house in Dubai. I really hope you guys enjoy this video. I'll know how long this video will be after I'm done editing it. I know it's going to be a long one. And without further ado, let's just start the video. So this is what my bookshelf looks like from afar. I got this bookshelf from Amazon. I'm going to see if I can find a link of it, and if I do, I'll put it in the description box below. We put together this bookshelf ourselves. I wanted a bookshelf which had elements of wood and metal in it, so that is why I opted for this particular one. I've put some fairy lights around them. I got them from IKEA. And we've got a money plant and a basket with a cushion and a throw. So right next to my bookshelf, I have these two wall hangings. I got these both from Maison Dumont. One of them says, take a break, it's tea time. And the other one says, enjoy the little things. I love having these right next to my bookshelf. So let's start from the top shelf of my bookshelf. I have put a few Penguin classics on the leftmost side, and these ones are from Penguin Random House India. And then right next to them I have some vintage red spines, and then next to that I've got a basket with some classics I couldn't find a place to put. So let's go through these first. So I've got a card on top of this stack of books. This one is from my husband Vikas. He gave it to me before my exam. It says good luck, good fortune, good karma. I think you guys might have already seen it in my videos because it's usually right there in the background. So the first book is Hard Times by Charles Dickens. I love Hard Times. It's one of my favorite books by Charles Dickens. The second book in this edition which I own is Madame Bovary by Gustave Flaubert. I have not read this book yet. It's a French classic which I have been meaning to get to for ages. Crime and Punishment by Fyodor Dostoevsky. I've read this Russian classic and I loved reading it. Persuasion by Jane Austen. My favorite Jane Austen book ever, and wow, I've got a lot of favorites in these editions. And the last book which I own in this Penguin Random House Classics edition is Little Women by Louisa May Alcott. I read this book ages ago and I wish to reread it now, especially after I've seen the recent adaptation starring Emma Watson. Next to the Penguin Random House Classics, I've got some vintage red spines. The first one is A Country Doctor's Notebook by Mikhail Bulgakov. This is a collection of short stories and I loved reading them. It's a definite 5 out of 5 star book. The Trial by Franz Kafka. I read this last year and really enjoyed it. The Warden by Anthony Trollope. This is the first book in the Barsetshire Chronicles series. Moll Flanders by Daniel Defoe. It was one of the first classics I started reading when I started this channel, and I remember I really liked it. Little Dorrit by Charles Dickens. It's also one of the best books by Dickens I've read. I feel like I barely have got any issues with Charles Dickens anymore, and this is one book I really enjoyed. Wives and Daughters by Elizabeth Gaskell, another masterpiece. David Copperfield by Charles Dickens. I read it in January 2020 and I loved it. There are going to be a lot of classics in this bookshelf tour, I'm afraid. The first book which I've got in my basket is The Good Soldier by Ford Madox Ford. This book I haven't read yet. Next, I've got Absalom, Absalom by William Faulkner, another classic which I haven't read yet. The Cranford Chronicles by Elizabeth Gaskell. I read it last year and I absolutely loved reading this book by Elizabeth Gaskell. Sense and Sensibility by Jane Austen. This is in the Vintage Classics Library edition. I've read this book and I'm afraid it is one of my least favorite books by Jane Austen. The Importance of Being Earnest and Other Plays by Oscar Wilde. This is also an unread book. The Great Gatsby by F. Scott Fitzgerald. I read this book ages ago and I wish to reread it soon. Emma by Jane Austen. I believe these are the only four books in the Vintage Classics Library edition which I own and have with me in Dubai. So I've put these books in the basket because I couldn't find more place on the bookshelf. So right on top of the bookshelf, I'm not sure if you guys can see it, but I've got my copy of the Holy Quran. Let me give you guys a peek. It's a copy of the Holy Quran in Arabic. So my second shelf holds some Penguin Black Classics and some Penguin Popular Classics edition. And right beside that, I've got a bottle with a money plant and some dried petals from a rose which my husband gave me a while back. So let's start from the Penguin Black Classics. Can You Forgive Her by Anthony Trollope. This is the first book in the Palliser series by Anthony Trollope, and it was an absolutely amazing book. Plus, I love the cover. I think the painting, it's stunning. Let me check what the name of this painting is. It's called Nordic Summer Evening. The second book is Candid or Optimism by Voltaire. It's a French classic which I have not read yet. The Painter of Signs by R.K. Narayan. This is written by an Indian writer. The Whirlpool by George Gissing. This is a Victorian classic which I haven't read yet. The Strange Case of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde by Robert Louis Stevenson. The Black Tulip by Alexander Dumas. It's a French classic which I read a couple of years ago. The Shape of Things to Come by H.G. Wells. It's a non-fiction by a Victorian writer. The War of the Worlds by H.G. Wells. The Brothers Karamazov by Fyodor Dostoevsky. It's a Russian classic and I read it last year and I absolutely fell in love with it. So these were all the Penguin Black Classics. Now let's go on to some Penguin Popular Classics, which are right next to these ones. Jude the Obscure by Thomas Hardy. I haven't read this Victorian classic yet. I think it doesn't count as Victorian because he wrote it after the end of the Victorian era, but it is by Thomas Hardy. The Ambassadors by Henry James, another book cover which I absolutely love. Martin Chuzzlewit by Charles Dickens. I haven't read this book yet. Mrs. Dalloway by Virginia Woolf, another unread book. Dr. Thorne by Anthony Trollope. It's a book in the Barsetshire Chronicles series. And the last Penguin popular classic on this shelf is Vanity Fair by William Makepeace Thackeray. This book has been on my TBR for ages. So these were all the books on the second shelf. Let's zoom out now and move down to my third bookshelf. I don't know why. So this is my third shelf. So on this bookshelf, I've got some Oxford World Classics, some Penguin English Library editions. In fact, these are all the Penguin English Library editions which I own. And in the middle, I've got some random collection of books, just a mix and match of different editions. So let's start with the Oxford World Classics first. Bel Ami by Guy de Maupassant. This is a French classic. I have watched the film for Bel Ami, but I haven't read this book yet. Orley Farm by Anthony Trollope, another unread book. East Lynne by Ellen Wood. I have read this book, I really enjoyed it. Mary, The Wrongs of Woman by Mary Wollstonecraft. I read this book, I guess last year. I thought it was an interesting read. The writing apart, I really liked the cover of this edition. I think the picture of the woman on the cover is gorgeous. The Eustace Diamonds by Anthony Trollope. This is the third book in the Palliser series by Anthony Trollope. And the last Oxford World's Classics edition which I own is The Odd Women by George Gissing. Another favorite book of mine. I absolutely love this book. So all of the Oxford World's Classics edition I own are in the older editions by Oxford. I've only got one in the newer edition, and I'm sure you guys can see the odd one out in this stack. Coming to the middle section of my third shelf, I've got I Capture the Castle by Dodie Smith. This is a coming-of-age story, a middle-grade classic. Felix Holt the Radical. This is the Wordsworth Classic Edition. It's the older editions by Wordsworth. The Master and Margarita by Mikhail Bulgakov. This is a Russian classic. I love these pocket classics by Penguin. They are so cute. I've just got this one edition, but I really like the concept behind these classics. All the Russian books are red in color, so on and so forth. Swing Time by Zadie Smith, the only modern book on my shelves so far. Grimm's Fairy Tales by Jacob and Wilhelm Grimm. Jane Eyre by Charlotte Bronte. Two books I recently got and I absolutely love these editions. The first one is Silas Marner by George Eliot, and the second one is The Turn of the Screw by Henry James. These classics are also by Penguin Random House. They are vintage classics. Next, I've got a stack of really pretty books. These are the Penguin English Library editions by Penguin. The first one is Framley Parsonage by Anthony Trollope. The Small House at Allington by Anthony Trollope. Lady Audley's Secret by Mary Elizabeth Braddon. Villette by Charlotte Bronte. Middlemarch by George Eliot. One of my favorite books of all time. I love this book because it made me fall in love with classics. New Grub Street by George Gissing, a new Penguin English Library edition I have recently purchased. The Portrait of a Lady by Henry James. I have read this book. It's my least favorite by Henry James. So these were all the Penguin English Library editions, and now let's move on to the last shelf of this bookshelf. So this right here is the last shelf. I've got some Wordsworth's classics on the left side. I've got Collins classics on the right side. And in the middle, I've got some Penguin popular classics, and then some random books which I couldn't find a place for anywhere else. So let's start with the Collins classics first. The Woman in White by Wilkie Collins, The Iliad by Homer. I might be getting rid of this edition. I have purchased a better translation and I want to stick with that. So I'll be removing this and giving it away to an old bookshop. Northanger Abbey by Jane Austen, Shirley by Charlotte Bronte, and the last Collins classics which I have is Lady Chatterley's Lover by D.H. Lawrence. So these are all the Collins classics which I own. I am removing the Iliad because I plan to get rid of that edition. Alright, so here we've got a random collection of books. Woman Much Missed by Thomas Hardy and The Night Is Darkening Round Me by Emily Bronte. These are both collections of poems by these Victorian writers. Bonjour Tristesse by Francois Sagan. It's a book I read last year and didn't really love, so I'll be giving it away as well. The Red Pony by John Steinbeck, another book I didn't like and am planning to give away. Two books by George Orwell, Animal Farm and 1984. I absolutely love both of these books. A Tale of Two Cities by Charles Dickens. I haven't read this book yet. Tender is the Night by F. Scott Fitzgerald. The Phantom of the Opera by Gaston Leroux. Another French classic on my TBR. Lorna Doone by R.D. Blackmore. The Europeans by Henry James. The Return of the Native by Thomas Hardy, one of my favorite books by Thomas Hardy. So I have got these Wordsworth classics, which is a big stack. I'll try to go through them as quickly as I can. Mansfield Park by Jane Austen. Ethan Frome by Edith Wharton, another book I want to get rid of this year. Mary Barton by Elizabeth Gaskell. Resurrection by Lev Tolstoy. Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. Even looking at this book makes me so happy because I love this book. Tess of the D'Urbervilles by Thomas Hardy. This edition has such a pretty cover. The name of the painting is Whitewash by Lisa Jensen and I absolutely love it. The Mill on the Floss by George Eliot. The Woodlanders by Thomas Hardy. Daniel Deronda by George Eliot. 12 Years a Slave by Solomon Northup. An American Brat by Bapsi Sidhwa is the book which I am currently reading. So it's right here on the table where I can grab it whenever I want to read. And then I have placed the rest of my books on this table on my TV shelf. So I've placed a few books inside and then most of them are on the top. So let's start with the ones on the top first. So these books are in no particular order. So let's start with the books on this shelf. Shoe Dog by Phil Knight. This is a non-fiction. It's an autobiography by the creator of the brand Nike. Washington Square by Henry James. This is in the Arcturus Publishers edition. 21 Lessons for the 21st Century by Yuval Noah Harari. The 40 Rules of Love by Elif Shafak. The Crow Eaters by Bapsi Sidhwa. The Plague by Albert Camus. The Picture of Dorian Gray by Oscar Wilde. In the Penguin Clothbound edition, this is a hardback. Marriage by Susan Ferrier. Stories for Our Time by Anton Chekhov. This is a collection of short stories. Milton Place by Elizabeth DeWall. This is in the Persephone Classics edition and I love the cover, the minimal look of this book. The Butchering Art by Lindsay Fitzharris. This is a non-fiction about medicine during the Victorian era. The Scarlet Letter by Nathaniel Hawthorne. The Gambler by Fyodor Dostoevsky. The Prince by Niccolo Machiavelli. Rebecca by Daphne du Maurier. Discontent and Its Civilizations by Mohsen Hamid. Born a Crime by Trevor Noah. another non-fiction and autobiography, Oliver Twist by Charles Dickens. This is the vintage classics edition for the Charles Dickens books, and I love these. And the last book on this shelf is Reclaim Your Heart by Yasmeen Mujahid. So the first one is the Iliad by Homer. This is in the Robert Fagles translation. The Odyssey by Homer, another Robert Fagles translation. And the last is the Aeneid by Virgil. This is also in the Robert Fagles translation. And these editions are Penguin Classics Deluxe Editions. Dr. Zhivago by Boris Pasternak in the Vintage Russian Classics Edition. The translation is by Richard Peaver and Larissa Wolkonski. And next I've got this massive book, War and Peace by Lev Tolstoy. This is also translated by Richard Peaver and Larissa Wolkonski. And these editions match because they are both from the vintage Russian classics edition. So I've got a candle right next to these two books, and then two baskets with some scented flowers, a small vase, a clock which was a wedding present from some friends, and another vase. So that's it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video, and if you did, please don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already, and I'm going to see you all in my next video very, very soon. Inshallah. Bye.